Dear learners, welcome to the NIOS Studios. I'm Dr. Shivani Datta from University of Delhi, and I'm here to talk about growth and development. In this lesson, we would be discussing the basic concept of growth first. Now, what do you understand by growth? It refers to a quantitative change in the body. We all know that we are multicellular beings. Our body is made up of millions and billions of cells. Now, when the body is growing, the cells that constitute the body, they multiply and they increase in number. Consequently, with this increase, there's an increase in height and weight, as well as changes in the body proportions. All these changes are numerically quantifiable. For example, I can very well know the exact increase in my height in terms of centimeters or inches. Now, changes, interestingly, continue to occur in all domains of development. The changes that take place in the physical domain of children, they become most visible and apparent, and they're easily quantifiable. For instance, the increase in height and weight is easily quantifiable and is quite visible. But there are certain domains where the changes are not that easily quantifiable. For instance, it is very difficult for us to quantify changes in language development. Now, how do I quantify it? I can't be talking in terms of the increase in the number of words that the child is uttering. For instance, say that a month back the child was uttering some 10 words per minute, and now the child is capable of uttering 40 words per minute. This is not possible, it's not that simple. So how do I understand changes with respect to this domain? Now, changes with respect to these domains can be understood in a qualitative manner. For instance, I could be talking about understanding the qualitative nature of change in terms of the complexity of language usage. For instance, maybe a month back, the child was formulating very simple sentences comprising of some 2-3 words, and now the child is well equipped to formulate complex sentences, maybe using 8-9 words in a sentence formation. So one of the most important features of growth is that these changes are measurable. If you can't measure them, it is very difficult to comment about growth. Now, the initial few years witness remarkable growth in almost every domain. So you have domains of sensory motor development, you have language acquisition, you have cognitive development. These are the various domains in which growth and development happens. Now, you will be surprised to know that between birth and first year of life, a well-nourished child can undergo almost 50% increase in height. And a newborn actually doubles his or her birth weight by 6 months of age and triples it by the time the newborn completes first year of life. Now, if you look at the table given by ICMR, you can actually clearly see the rapid growth in the weight and height of children during the initial few years only. So that is the pace at which the child is growing rapidly. Now, when we talk about these physical markers, a steady increase in both height and weight is considered to be a good indicator of satisfactory physical growth. During the initial few visits to the pediatrician, the height and weight of the baby is constantly monitored to check if the baby is not lagging behind. Other than these markers of height and weight, another important feature that needs to be kept in mind is the changes in the body proportions. You must have noticed that when a baby is born, the head of the newborn looks disproportionately large compared to the rest of the body. The body is not proportionate at all. Later, body proportions change and the head does not look that big and becomes proportionate to the rest of the body. Also, when children are born, their arms, they appear to be longer in proportion to their legs. At birth, legs are short, they face each other, and as they grow in length, they straighten out. Now, as a result of these growth and changes, the body of the child starts looking more and more proportionate. And these changes are very important because it is through these changes that the child would be gaining muscular composure and would be attaining better balance. Now, in this lecture, since we are equipped with the basic understanding of concept of growth, it's very interesting to note that quantitative growth that we've just spoken about is half the story. It does not occur in isolation. Rather, there's a parallel spurt of development also occurring, something that we would be discussing in subsequent lectures. Thank you.